Hello everyone, so today we'll start with Newton-Gregory forward and backward interpolation formula. Newton-Gregory forward interpolation formula is P into X naught plus R into H is equal to Y naught plus delta Y naught divided by 1 factorial into R plus delta square Y naught by 2 factorial into R minus 1 plus etc. The terms goes on. So how to remember this formula? It's very easy. So see here, first will be Y naught, then delta Y naught, delta square y naught, delta cube y naught, delta to the power of 4 y naught, delta to the power of 5 y naught, it goes on, okay. Next will be, first term is only y naught. From second term starts, divided by 1 factorial, divided by 2 factorial, divided by 3 factorial, divided by 4 factorial, goes on. So you can remember this power of delta will be the factorial, okay. And next here, first term is only y naught. Next, r into r minus 1. Next R into R minus 1 into R minus 2. Again next term will have R into R minus 1 into R minus 2 into R minus 3 and so on. Okay. So now let's get into a problem. So our first problem is find the value of Y when X is equal to 116 given that X is equal to 100 of 10 of 130. Here this is your H value and X starts from 100 and ends at 130, that is interval is 10. Say first x naught is 100, x1 will be 100 plus 10, that is 110. Again x2 will be 110 plus 10. So next values you are adding plus 10, okay. So we'll see that how to enter that. So it is first value x naught is 100, next value x will be 100 plus 10, 110. Next value will be 110 plus 10, that is 120. Then next value will be 120 plus 10, that is 130. 130 is the last value, you have to stop there. Okay. So next, entries of Y, they have only given, that is 10, 9.02, 8.34 and 7.69. Okay. Next, we are finding, this is, okay. Find the value of Y, we are doing for forward difference, it will be mentioned in the question, so okay, I'll just put it on the question. The complete question will be like this using Newton-Gregory forward interpolation formula, they'll mention it, okay. So we have forward interpolation formula, that means forward difference table. So we have delta, what is it, 9.02 minus 10 gives you minus 0.98. So forward we are placing from the first line. So the difference is placed from the first line. Either you can place it in between these two values or you can start from the first line for forward difference. Again now this minus this gives you minus 0.68. Again this number minus this number gives you minus 0.65. Again next we have our delta square. What is it? This number minus this number is 0.3. Again this number minus this number is 0.3. Again we have our delta cube. That is 0.3 minus 0.3 is, sorry, 0.03 this was, 0.3 minus 0.03 is minus of 0.27. Okay, so now we have a formula. Why are we writing till delta cube y naught is? We have the table till delta cube y naught. We are obtaining the single value at this point, right? So now substitute these values here, okay? So we have P of x naught plus rh. So P of x naught plus rh, we don't know the value of r. So we have x naught plus rh that is this can be taken as x. So P of x. So here what is the x value we are supposed to find? 116. That means P of X will be 116. So comparing these two X's here, X naught plus RH, this X will be 116, this X naught plus RH. What is the X naught value? X naught value is 100. Plus we don't know R, we know H value to be 10, right? Is equal to 116. Now can we find out R value? Yes, right? So what is R value? R of 10 is equal to 116 minus 100. R is equal to 16 divided by 10, which is nothing but R is equal to 0.1.6. 6. So now substituting the value of r also in the given formula, what do you have? We have p of x naught plus rh. So that is nothing but x naught plus rh is 116, right? We are comparing here, right? So that is equal to y naught value. What is the y naught value? Y naught value is 10 plus, what is delta y naught value? It is -0.998. delta square y naught value is this, again delta cube y naught value is this. So you can mark here to be this is the values you are going to use in the formula. You have to mark this, okay? So if you are writing the forward difference table or backward difference table, placing the values in between, you will get the table to be like this. Okay, so your marking will be a little cross, that's all. But the values are same, table is same, entries are same. Okay? Okay, now let's enter these values. So we got 10. Now we have delta y naught. What is delta y naught value? First is 10, next value is this. Yes, -0.98 into, divided by 1 factorial is 1. What is r value? Into 1.6 plus delta square y naught is next value, that is 0.3. 0.3 into r into 2 factorial, divided by 2 factorial is 2 into 1. So we are writing 2 into r is 1.6 into r minus 1 is 1.6 minus 1 plus, again we have delta cube by naught, that is -0.27 into, divided by 3 factorial, that is 3 into 2 into 1, right? Into r minus 1 into r minus 2. So I'll write that here, into r minus 1 into r minus 2, right? Now simplify this, we will get the answer. So here is a solution, 10 minus this numbers we will get. P of 116 is nothing but 8.5932. Newton-Gregory backward interpolation formula. The formula is P of xn plus r into h is equal to yn plus nabla yn divided by 1 factorial into r, nabla square yn divided by 2 factorial into r plus 1 plus nabla cube yn into r minus 1 into r minus 2 divided by 3 factorial. So here also you can remember the formula easily. Here xn plus rh, here yn, delta nabla yn, nabla square yn, nabla cube yn. Here first r into r plus 1, r into r plus 1 into r plus 2. Then you have 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial. What is the difference between forward and backward interpolation formulas? Forward you have x naught and you have y naught, and also you have r minus 1, r minus 2, etc. like that. Okay, let's check out the first problem. Find y when x is equal to 37.5, where arguments are given and y values entries are given using Newton-Gregory backward interpolation formula. So first what you have to do, you have to put the table. So here's a table, arguments we have entered, entries and we have entered. Since they have given entries after decimal point, four digits, fix your calculator to four decimal places, okay? Now nabla, that means backward table, you are starting from the end, right? So this number minus this number gives you 0.784, which you are placing in the last line. Again this number minus this number gives you 1.0017, this number minus this number gives you 1.2786, again this number minus this number gives you 1.6277. okay, again we have nabla square come from the bottom, that is 0.784 minus 1.0017 gives you minus 0.2168, again minus 0.2769, this number minus this number is this, again this number minus this number is minus 0.3491. we have nabla cube, that is this number minus this number, what do you get? 0.0602. again this number minus this number gives you 0.0722. Again, subtract these two, you will get -0.0121. Okay, that is nabla to the power of 4. So now here we have a formula. You can observe that we have yn, delta yn, delta square yn, delta cube yn. So where it is? This is delta y1, y2, y3, y4. Yn is, now in this case, 4, right? So these are the values you are going to enter. So you have to mention this. Okay. If you are writing in between, your table is a little slant. So you can check that out here. Your table will be like this. Same number, same values, everything. The placement is in between. So you will have a cross marking. That's all. Okay. So we have, we will enter the values. What? Okay. Before that, we have to find out R, right? So xn plus RH is equal to P of X. So what is the X value they have given? They have given 37.5, right? So this implies we have xn plus rh is equal to 37.5. What is the r value? What is the xn value first of all? Xn value is this last value of x. 40 plus r into what is h value? They have not given directly the h value. So second number minus first number gives you the h value. That is the interval. So 20 plus 5 is 25. 25 plus 5 is 30. 30 plus 5 is 35. So what is your h value? H value is 5 is equal to 37.5. So what's your r value? This implies r is equal to -0.5. So after calculation, we'll get the r value to be -0.5. So p of 37.5 is equal to, what is yn value? Yn value is this, that is 17.1591 plus, what is delta yn value? This is next value, that is 0.784 divided by 1 factorial is 1. R value is -0.5 plus, again you have delta square y naught. Yn will be the first value used, second value used, third value will be delta square yn, that is -0.2168 into r value is -0.5 into r plus 1 is -0.5 plus 1 divided by 2 factorial, that is 2 into 1 plus, again you have delta cube yn. So we already used first 3, the delta cube yn will be this value, 0.0602 divided by 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1. Again you have r is -0.5 into -0.5 plus 1. Again -0.5 plus 2 plus what is delta power 4? Sorry, nabla power 4, 0.0121. Sorry, I have told all as delta. It is nabla. Representation is nabla we finish with the delta nabla power 4 is 4 of yn is this -0.0121 divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 into we have r into r plus 1 into r plus 2 into r plus 3. So solution, after solving, what do you get? Multiply all these, divide by 2, multiply all these, divide by 3, multiply all these, divide by 4. 3 is not 3 here, 3 2 is a 6 here, it is 4 3 is a 12, 12 2 is a 24. So we have, after calculation, everything. What is P of 37.5? A P of 37.5 is 16.7904. Thank you.